How's it going, you guys, and welcome to your morning call. DRDO's new oral drug to well protect you from COVID. We understand that it's got various phases, but something important that we need to talk about is the fact that it's got extensive clinical trials that are already in place. You see, phase 1 data suggested that the molecules work effectively against the SARS-CoV-2 virus. And based on this phase, well, phase 3, because phase 2 was successful, came into play in December 2020, finally again in March 2021 with 220 patients, thereby further dictating the fact that this was a very prevalent and worked very well. You see, the 2DG drug is a generic molecule and an analog of glucose, so it can be easily produced and made available in large quantities. We also understand that the second batch of the drug will be coming around by 27th of May in a limited amount of quantity. So that is the first amount of this drug that is ever going to be hitting the markets. And whoever manages to receive these drugs in initial doses might just be really helpful for those people in terms of trying to protect themselves or trying to increase their immunity thresholds when it comes to dealing with the pandemic. We understand the fact that a New Zealand flight with 50 ill and disabled children draws giant kiwi in the sky. Now, this was no normal ordeal. This was a very special flight which was around the country. It was organized by a New Zealand based charity called Koru Care, and a picture of the route was posted onto Twitter by Flight Radar 24. This photo has received upwards of 4,000 likes since then, making it a very special thing in the middle of a pandemic wherein people are, well, losing hope quickly. A 16-year-old boy captured the clearest picture of the moon and the picture went viral. Prathamesh Jaju, a 16-year-old from Pune, a place where I was for upwards of 10 years and I love Pune, has gone viral on social media because he captured one of the most viral and detail-oriented pictures of the moon. He said that he took over 50,000 images and captured for around 4 hours. It took around 38 to 40 hours of processing, and the reason behind 50,000 pictures is because he stitched them all together and created essentially what Google Maps creates as well, what NASA creates as well. A stitched image is always going to be more detail oriented, and the details will not get lost as you further zoom into an image. So this detail orient was brought to you by a 16-year-old from Pune, India, the clearest picture of the moon there ever was. Now, this is another controversial thing to talk about, but Bill Gates had hoped that Jeffrey Epstein, the person who was jailed for sex offenses, for embezzlement, for tons of fraud, for a bunch of charges, and who ended up so-called committing suicide in his prison cell. Well, it turns out that him and Bill Gates had a lot of close meetings, and it turns out that he, being Bill Gates, was under the impression that Jeffrey Epstein could help him win a Nobel Peace Prize. A former Gates Foundation employee has claimed. The employee claims that Gates thought that Jeffrey would know the right people or some kind of a way to message things around. Gates' spokesperson, however, has come out about this allegation and denied the accusations, adding that Gates was not obsessed with the Nobel Peace Prize and he by no means needed the Nobel Peace Prize to feel, well, whatever justification follows, or gratification rather, follows the Nobel Peace Prize around. 146 rescued from a barge P305 amid the cyclone Tuakte. We understand that the barge was off the coast of Bombay, of Mumbai, and Defence Public Relations Officer said that 196 personnel were on board the SS3 and 101 personnel on Sagar Bhushan are safe. Offshore supply vessels are hired by the ONGC and the SCI, towing them to safety because the ships, unfortunately, are no longer in the condition of functioning on their own accord. After cyclone Tuatke, we understand that the Indian Meteorological Department has warned of a new cyclone that possibly might be on the other side of the equation, that means in the Bay of Bengal. We understand that a low pressure area is likely to form around May the 23rd that might intensify into a depression and ultimately into a cyclone. Sunita Devi, who monitors cyclones at the IMD, has said that a bulletin to this effect has been released and people are already being warned, especially the fishing communities near the Bay of Bengal and the eastern coast of India. One more dead due to the black fungus in Uttarakhand, and well, this issue is now turning into something rather serious, because another pandemic with the black fungus will not be fun for anyone to imagine. We've already reached 3 digits in terms of people who have already contracted the disease, and double digits in the scenario of people who have lost their lives. We understand that a 36-year-old had initially died due to the infection on Friday. And the doctor added that 5 more patients have been well admitted because of symptoms of the black fungus. He said that the black fungus is something that cannot be taken lightly and is very, very contagious. So thereby bringing in a whole new ball game of a new normal when we are at constant fronts with microbes that are out to get us. Be it viruses or bacteria or fungi, it turns out that there is more microbial action against the human species as a whole than you and I can begin to wrap our heads around. The Israel Defense Forces tweeted, 4 rockets were just fired from Lebanon at the northern Israeli front, one of which was intercepted by the Iron Dome. In response, the Israel Defense Forces artillery forces are striking a number of targets in Lebanon. We are prepared for scenarios in any front. What did we talk about when he initially said in the past 2 days that people are going to be forced to pick sides? And if people start to pick sides, is this going to turn into a war zone? Unlike what we've seen before, proxy wars are going to be lit in the region. Countries that are thousands of miles away will be involved, and there will be copious amounts of loss of life, of resources, collateral damage, the likes of which you can't understand. And the world in the middle of a pandemic does not need infighting. But here we go. First with Gaza, now in Lebanon, Israel is at war.